Today is the second day of the Humanitarian Innovators Network Lab that's co-hosted by EMOPS, the Office of Emergencies, and the Innovation Unit in UNICEF. The idea behind the lab was to bring together predominantly our colleagues from the field who have been working in emergencies for many years and to put them together with external partners, the crisis mappers, USAIDI, various partners like that that are really kind of at the forefront of innovation. Also our sister agency partners, and to really reflect on how innovation can help us improve our humanitarian action.
We're here to listen to each other and learn from each other, taking from one experience to connect it to another one and make something new in order to deliver better.
And we're trying to improve how UNICEF has been working up to now and trying to address some key issues that will help us to better deliver, to better reach affected populations.
What's really exciting is that people are feeling absolutely free to come up with solutions that are way outside of our current regulatory or procedural environment. The facilitators are making us use post-its and graphs and even drawings. The theory is that this forces us to use the other part of our brain. So if I'm drawing, I'm activating parts of my brain that will help me find new and original solutions that I might not think about if I was in my usual comfort zone.
It makes you feel like a kid, actually, but that's all right. I'm even thinking of taking some of these ideas back to my country office. Lesser presentation, more physical work, very engaging. And I think that's a really good idea.
It's nice to try new stuff, and it's nice to do it collectively, like with a group at a table. So this gives you, you can see how other people think. So I think it's quite stimulating.
For me, innovation is about doing things differently in a very cost-effective and efficient manner to make sure that we make the right decisions and the right choices so that we put our resources to the right people and, for that matter, children.
Taking risks by keeping the vision. That is innovation. Innovation is also accepting to fail. Because failing and succeeding, it's the same couple.
The world continues to change and pose new challenges for us. So we know for a fact that the caseload or the number of people affected by crises will only grow and that the situations will be more and more complex. But we do think that innovation can help us thinking about new ways to address them.